comes in a very fun game, but I must say it's very tough. I can see why I still don't have property now. There's a lot to learn, and I can see that there's a lot of process from, you know, looking for the right property and then going to the bank. The bank is one of the most difficult part. You know, always cannot go through, cannot get loan, and yeah, it gives me how to say, allows me to see how it's like in real life. I'm not really sure if it's the same outside, because I heard some people who give like comments saying that you can go through different ways and all, but this is definitely a starting for me, and it allows me to give me a lot of value. So I want to thank Sven for this game. Yeah, thank you.
Who else? So what do you observe about yourself from there?
Okay.
Have a good one. Thank you.
Yeah.
What do you observe about yourself? What are the things that you should have done better?
Collaborate.
Collaborate with who?
Among people.
Who
want to buy property.
Yes.
So actually, basically that is the real scenario, that 60% of the loan reduction in the real world, right? So right now you are really facing that a lot of criteria that bank is looking at. So how to beautify your income statement, that how to prove that you have additional income and show bank that your ability, that is very important. Okay, if you cannot do it yourself, then you join with others. Okay, but then basically in the real life situations, if you are not coupled or you are not any relating, they are very hard to grant you. But then always a good banker, okay, always a good banker can give you an advice. So the key thing is you need a good key banker. Okay, because when a banker is in the middle, you are let's say you want to buy something, but then the decision maker basically is Morgan Pickering Cash. Can you access her?
No.
The credit department, can you access her?
Eventually.
Oh, can you access her? Yes or no?
No.
No.
Eventually.
Yeah.
You get some connection or you get some approval, but then the percentage is almost this very limited.
Yeah.
Right? So the persons that behind the bank is doing to process all your loan documents, basically they don't know you. They just look at the paper. The numbers show on the paper. So they are based on every number to grant you that whether they want to reject or give you the loan. So the banker in the middle, the person, is very important. If a good banker, they always can advise you. They will advise you that how much income you need to top up, or you can find guarantor, or you can join income with others, right? They always can help you. In my real case, my first property, by the time my income is 2004, my property price is 800K. How am I going to buy? Three names join together to buy this property. And when I buy the time, we are unrelated. Our banker is very, very good. When he do the supporting document and he do everything, he say that we are cousins. Different surname, but then we are cousins. Eventually, we get the loan. We get the loan from our bank. So I just want to tell you that a lot of scenario is you able to make it when you have a good banker, and the banker have a very good relationship in the inner circle. So, this is a very key thing for you also, yeah, for you getting this. Because everything is just from paper, they don't know you, they are very hard to grant you anything. Because bank is doing business as well. Yeah, so every recording on your bank statement, you should take a look, especially commissioner income earner. You need to take a look because they are using 6 months. Okay, let's say 1 year, they will use 6 months, 50% of your income, and you need to provide 6 months income statement. For the fixed one, they are okay because you are every time you have a certain amount in your bank, so they trace it, especially your EPF as well. EPF, income tax, okay, this you need to make it nicely. This is all your accounting. I can feel that, I can know that when you guys do it, the accounting a bit frustration. But then that is very important, is go back to the paycheck, track all progress. And every number you need to know exactly. Yeah.
So first of all, Steph, really intense game. I really liked it. I learned a lot. And how it reflected for me, and one of the key things that I took away from it was being in a role has advantages and it also has disadvantages. Because running around with the asset cards didn't necessarily translate into more income. Like, what it did primarily was allow me access to Alpha Builder, which was really where the main value came from. Like, basically being able to stand next to Alpha Builder and just saying, what do I do? I have no idea what I'm doing. I don't know how to do this. What do I do? So in hindsight, what I witnessed in the game was essentially how my business has been. I'm not in the property business, but I've seen essentially like my property business, or my business show up this way, where I'm so focused in the beginning on doing the service, on generating the revenue from the actions that are being taken. So I was working really hard to get commissions and to focus on that and to create the sales for the people and being of service. And it was at the end, towards the end of the game, that I was just like, this is stupid. That's a stupid model. And Alpha Builder said you need to be working with people to have them create more cash flow in order to create the collaborations. And so even though there were agreements in place with several different people for us to process things faster, we weren't necessarily generating revenue as a result of that. And the minute that we started going forward on it, we would have been approved for a much larger property. Like, knowing the numbers now, the first thing I would have done is I would have scoured all the event cards and like, which one is complete first, which one's going to give me rental first, which one can I afford, who do I bring in order to match like our stuff. So I can see the power of the collaboration there, immediately creating more cash flow, and from the cash flow then being able to do more. I think the game was brilliant because there's so many things. It's the first time I've ever had a game where I manage my cash flow every single quarter on time, right, at the expense of survival, but on time. So SSM would be very happy, but I would die now. So, because the thing that I realized was that in the following the execution and committing myself to all of the standards that needed to be there, I essentially dragged myself into a lot of work I didn't need to be in. So there was a point early in the game where we were talking about collaboration and we walked away from it, and then only came back to it later. So it was very interesting to see the behavior patterns that showed up, where collaboration was an opportunity for us. I think like quarter two in 2-2-2.
Yeah.
We began the portion of collaboration and we had a lot of information and we did nothing with it. Basically. Which is super interesting. So the game is really good. The game really demonstrates behavior in a really powerful way. And also the exhaustion that comes from that, this is just my own observation for myself, there's just an exhaustion that comes from managing the paperwork and managing the distraction and managing the conversations and basically having the ins and outs and needing a really organized system. So I said this several times, but my one takeaway is outsource everything. just be like, here's my, I give you my money. But the game is great. I can completely see it. I wish it was longer. That would be the only thing. Like, I wish I had like 8 hours to play it. Because I feel as though towards the end I was starting to get into the groove of it, and I think the money would really start flowing from that point. So yeah, so thank you very much.
So I just want to add on my observation. So in the beginning you will feel that you don't know anything. I can see everyone, especially. So it's in the real life it's the same. If you pay something you don't know, you don't ask for it, you don't find out, then you won't know. So it's like, if you find out what is the rules of the game, you exactly know how to play the game, you will intuit. Because it's so easy for you. Okay? So know how the rules work for you is can help you to manipulate the system that you set. Everyone have their own different objective, so you need to understand. you already works, you buy the first property and from this way you already earn money, so you just manipulate it. Yeah. So you can create your own system based on your own behavior. Good? So you need to step out. Okay, like this game you already know what is your property, you will know that what the next step you're going to do. Some of you come to me for coaching. I'm willing to coach for it. Okay, so if you ask for information, I will tell you when. Yeah, if you don't ask, you scratch yourself, then you will be dead. Okay, so hungry for coaching is very important. Okay, good.
Who else for coaching?
Hi everyone, my name is Hilson.
Hi.
So I think in this game, what I realized that lawyers earn a lot of money. Right, so if you can see the score that I got was 126,425. Now however, if you were to play this game a bit longer, I will notice that actually that is not the highest amount. Operation, right? It's actually to invest in property. So that's where you can see your asset and your asset grow. However, because I think the time that you play this game is not long enough, therefore there's not much transactions happening so far. Second thing that I learned is actually as a lawyer, even though you can make a lot of money, you still also have to think of ways to invest your money. Right, if you look at Robert Kiyosaki's book about the quadrant, if you are just a business owner, you are forever a business owner. Though I actually expanded my business, I hired a lawyer to take over my job. I was about to go into the investment mode and that's where the game ends. Because I got a lot of cash flow, I want to invest in the property. So, number three, I also learned the importance of track all your progress. Because I noticed because I was too busy doing a lot of my legal work, I don't have time to also write down my in and out cash flow. And that is the reason I also don't know how much money I have. Right, so that is the learning that I got.
So what are the things that you have done better?
One of the things I can done better is that I would say hire more people, yeah, no doubt. Yes, that's one way I can do that. But I have to split my cost as well, my profit if I hire more lawyers. I think I've chosen my role, I volunteered myself to be in the category of handling the legal aspect. I would say I will delegate my task. I'll delegate my task and start to go into the property investment. That will actually make me play this game better as well as to learn how to invest better.
Yes.
Event card, but there's an opportunity there.
opportunity there because I got twice my salary income increased 600. Timing is quite important because I saw the seller selling the house for 50%. But I buy the house for 1.5 years, but I still have to buy for my process still under a quite tiring for buying a house. Thank you.
To share one thing, to know your number is because when you buy a house, it's take 4 years, 3 to 4 years currently, right? So in the beginning, you have a lot of upfront costs. And then in the middle, you have some interest. Then after you maybe you take the key, you need to give all the payment like assessment, rent. The thing is, after 4 years, after 3 years, you will forget everything. You will forget that when you sell the property that time, most of the people will forget that what is the upfront cost. Right? So every number in this 4 year time, you should note down and calculate that every expenses you keep up. Yeah, because it's too loose. It's like sometimes this one, then after that, 2 months after that for another payment, 2 months after that for another payment. So at the end, what mostly matters is just that what is my buying, what is my loan, and what is I get. The thing is, you actually didn't deduct all the costs because you cannot remember. So trees of accounting is very important if you are an investor.
I noticed just now there are some of you who are supposed to come and ask me for signature, right? Yes?
Yes.
Yeah. Now the first 2 quarters of signature, then the rest of you no signature. Yeah? A lot. So what does it mean? It means that you don't track your progress.
And?
Sorry, you said? Of course, you have penalty. In the real world, you have penalty for sure.
For
sure. Some of you, what, 1.5 years no signature. So that is how many? That's for 6 quarters. 6 quarters no signature.
And basically, the event card is an opportunity. You miss the opportunity.
Yes. So in that 6 quarters, you miss, you miss 12 opportunities. You miss 12 opportunities. So if you keep track of your progress on a quarterly basis, in the long term, you can actually track the expenses of the property that you're investing in. That's what she mentioned just now. Property is a long term thing. It's not a 6 month or 1 year, it's 4 years. So if you practice to do all the tracking system properly, then you will not have issues. You will definitely not have issues. And it's easier for you to track your loan amount, what income you need to put in. If you want to buy certain properties, this is the amount of the value of the property. You need to know how much income I have to earn more.
So right now, technically,
the
technology is very advanced. Look for apps. So look for apps and those are calculations that the formula is there for you. You just need to spend time to. Because every one of us is too busy. We are not purely just investor or homeowner. We just like we have normal job as well, right? So these all things, after you set it already, you have a habit already, then you just do repeat. Every time you will know what to do. Okay?
Who else want to share?
Yes.
Jenny?
Huh? Why me?
Yeah,
I think it's the same.
Yes.
I love my job
logic.
Because I love my boss.
She's
not
going to
be a bonus.
Sorry?
No bonus, but. Now what we talk under people. Hello everyone, my name is Janie.
Hi Janie.
What I learned here, now I understand in properties there are so many rules. Definitely, I cannot understand that all. But I'm very grateful because there are people out there that I have somehow able to build a relationship with them, then they help me to process the part, the area that I'm not good at, and yeah, because of my profession is a saver, then okay, so one thing is I need to get the professions to help me to handle the things that I'm not skillful at. Secondly is, if you are an agent, you don't sell what you want to sell, you sell what people want to buy. So I'm very fast at it. I can distribute my properties out. And maybe if you are an agent, yeah.
Thank you.
So from the crew point of view, what did you guys observe?
Hello everyone, my name is Michelle.
Hi Michelle.
Okay, so I was the builder. So what I observed is as a property agent, like what Jenny said, you need to know what the market wants. And also, because initially what I saw as a sayer, they are just, just simply grab all the asset card and just throw it out to the market. But eventually they didn't know that, this branch of market, they are not so high in income yet. Yeah. Then, secondly is, as an agent itself, you might need to go through, really help the people to go through the process. Yeah. And as a third party sitting there looking at all of you, it's like, it's a lot of people don't really understand the problem. Lot of your, but the thing is, what I find good is that eventually, round by round, you all slowly seems to get the process and started. Some of you started to build relationship with the sayer and even the loan
buyer.
Yeah, and I believe that might help, because the thing is, I myself as a property investor, you really need to have a very good relationship with agents. First is the agents, and then the banker, so that you can really get the property that you want. And as an investor itself, numbers is very crucial. So you need to understand what is your financial status. Because once, like for example, there might be some agents or developers who are selling a lot of different kind of properties. They will say that, this property is very good, blah, 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 and it's very cheap. You just need to put a down payment, 5,000 in fee. That 5,000 is quite easy to put in, right? But the thing is, you might need to see a long-term thing. Because eventually, how the property appreciates, it really depends on the surrounding developers, the reputations of the developers. Like, what,
no one asked you about this.
Yes, because in this iMarket, there are informations about the builders. So from there, you can really see which builders are really a good developer and their assets can appreciate. Yeah.
Am I the only one who bought this?
I think so.
Yeah. So that's why as an investor, you really need to know all these kind of developments surrounding your own. You also need to keep a very good record of your own self in terms of financial, so that the bank will really give you the approvals. Yeah. So this is what I also. Yeah. Thank you.
Which area is a faster growth, slow growth, and that shape, and what is the appreciations of the percentage on the each area, and the builder check. So none of them is like 4%.
Only 3% came in.
Okay, only 3% come over to buy the information, which means in this market there is a lot of information. But you guys, first thing is maybe you don't know where to get it. You didn't ask. So it's a lot of information to want to know. This is the most important part. I want to hit you.
Kaling.
Hi, Kaling.
Yeah, so basically, maybe I share what from my point of view as a bank developer. So just a quick question. Any of you here buy property is just for own state purpose? Will you raise your hand?
In real life, me?
Any?
In real life.
Okay. So any of you here buying property is for investment purpose? Will you guys raise your hand? Okay, so for those that want to buy property for investment purpose, right, do you guys have a number in head how many how many property that you want to purchase on? So any of you here just want to buy one for investment purpose? So any of you here want to buy three?
I don't
think we don't have property. Okay. So any of you here don't know any number yet? Oh, okay, understand. So I understand where you're coming from. Okay. So basically, I think you guys have the right, the intention of why you're coming here today is to learn how to invest in property, right? Okay, so it's good that you're playing this game. Reason why is because I'm not a hard person. Is that the banker part is really what happened in real life. Yeah, you need to know how to calculate the DSR or everything. So all these things and how you present to the bank. Yeah, so this is actually very important because the reason why I say so is because the first quarter, a lot of people bring a lot of high-end property, 1.4 million, 1.7 million to show me. Yeah, so by seeing that number and also your income, right, so it's actually it's like, with that amount of income, you actually not afford to buy the high-end property. Yeah, so imagine if you're not coming here today and you go out and purchase, or you're looking for with like 6,000 or 8,000, you're looking for 1.2 to 2 million kind of property. Will it cost you a lot of lessons in your life? How many of you agree on this? Can you raise your hand? Yeah, so this is very important things. As a banker, so this is what I see. So a lot of you actually knowledge would be the best word. Get knowledge and information in mind on what you need to do in order to invest in property. Because, yeah, so, okay, then back to the purchaser part. So in real life, okay, I'm also property investor. So I'm transacted. So which means transacted as buying I transacted more than 20 properties in my real life. Yeah, so which means I buy more than 20 properties. So the first thing that you need to know, definitely the loan part is the basic. So you need to show people how much you can borrow all those. But second thing that's more important part is actually you need to know how to find the information and also find a good deals. Yeah, because without knowing how to find information and good deal, and you simply use your salary to loan money, it will cost you a lot of not so good experience in your life. Yeah, so basically, to sum up, it's like, I think it's good that you have an experience through the whole property cycle, because it's really, if you want to buy a property, right, you really need to do some research, comparison, research, and those information in real life, there's actually some place that you can buy. Yeah, so, I don't know in KL, sorry, I'm from JB. So in JB, there is a place that you can buy past 1 year transactions price for property, only ringgit 60. So it's quite cheap. You can buy all this kind of information. You can do your own research based on your budget and go through loan. Yeah. So it's good that you guys can explore the whole process. Yeah. And also later on you can know what you want. So you can by knowing what you want, then you can plan ahead. How many property that you want to purchase and so on. Okay, thank you. So, to
to add on, that is a lot of learning over there. So you will know that you need to understand the supply and demand in the market. So the economy factor also will affect us. Let's say right now, yeah, all of you, the income level, we just can based on your income level, you can only loan like 500k of the property, right? So all the people right now, the youngster, and they will just develop, will based on this to build the house and price, have the price factor of it. So you can see right now the market a lot of 500k, 600k, right? So because when I price is 400k, when I bought it already, next I need to think who are they going to sell and who going to buy me. So if you buy a million property, let's say you buy a 1 million property, the next transaction you're going to sell, who is your target market going to buy? Is that a lot of people can get 1 million loan? No. So you already narrow down your target market as well. So you need to understand that right now, you let's say I price is 400k. The next one I sell 500k, right? Is it still got people want to buy? Yes. So think about it, what is the exit plan? You don't just buy because of value high. You buy is because the property is below market value. So the next question you will ask me, what is below market value? The first step you need to do is you stay in your area, right? Let's say I'm very familiar with Mokara. I roughly know that one condo is 1,000 PSF per square feet. We count by per square feet. Okay, every property we use per square feet. It's not, when you see the size and the price, the total price, right? You use the price to minus the build up. You use the price, your money to minus the build up. So let's say it's 1 million, it's 1,000 square feet build up. So PSF is what? The PSF is what? 1,000? Right? 1,000, right? So, and that kind of price, 1,000, is it in Mokara? Is it is higher price or lower price? That is how you know the market value. All the standard market value you can find in a lot of websites. Yeah, the transactor price. So that is how you look at, like, this is higher market value and or lower market value. This, in the game, you haven't go into it because the game not long enough. Yeah? So if you buy property at that time, the key is you always need to think how you can think. Anyone will buy from you. How much price you can increase? How much room they can get? Yeah? Okay. By the way, I will invite Tan. Mr. Tan actually is an amazing lawyer as well. He's a real lawyer. So he can give a lot of advice to us. I'm very happy and appreciate him to come over here. Yeah, so you can.
I'm pretty sure you still want to give the title. Alright, so was it fun dealing with lawyers?
Yes!
Sorry to my lawyer, in real life we always overlook our lawyers. You know and. Alright, today I would like to share some time and cost saving practical tips with you all. Especially in today's context, we know that time is a premium. Alright? And what I can observe is a lot of people are spending a lot of time negotiating or haggling on legal fees. Now, actually, in our setting, lawyers is the worst place to negotiate for the fees because we are the only law firm in this setting. But on the other hand, you have 4 or 5 property agents. So who is better for you to leverage on? It's the agents. You should pressure the agent to help you cover the legal costs rather than spending time because my lawyer is kind enough to give discount. He can actually say, I want 50%. You still have to pay because we are the only law firm. So why waste time discussing figures? Alright, in real life, it's the same thing. I have noticed that the most common excuse that you all use is, I will bring you more cases and then you give me discount. But in real life, are you really in the position to make that promise? No, you're not. Property agents are the people who can make that promise because they have a solid client base. So work your agents to negotiate your lawyers. You have a better chance of succeeding. Alright? I also noticed that only one transaction they actually purchase it with joint names. Alright? Again, time. premium, even though you shared the profit when you joined it, but you secured the deal fast. At least you lock down the property first. Because while you are trying to get the loan approval under your own name, you might lose the property. Agent myself and another eligible person. That is about that. Alright. Another thing I would like to share based on my observation is certain terminology you all need to find out before you allocate your money. Like I noticed I asked a few person how much a down payment and all that, they're not sure. In real life, down payment is cold hard cash and you need to put in. So you have to make sure you know how much and what is it about. Right? Because over here we are all on paper only, that's why you have negative. Alright. In real life, you don't have it means you don't have it. So all these are necessary information that you need to acquire first before you even step in. Otherwise, you might actually end up pretty bad. Yeah. So that's all that I can share for today.
Thank you. If you want to know more things, you can talk to Mr. Tan later on after the event. So now the next exercise is very simple. We would like you to just fill up the comment form. So at least we know what kind of things we can improve on.
So while you're doing that, I'm going to cover a few other things that are going on so that you can find out a little bit more information. So for how many of you was this an extremely, extremely valuable experience to play this game? How many of you got a lot of value out of this game? How many of you now know more than you ever started out with in terms of understanding the property market as a result of being inside the blue box? Yeah. And the reason that the games are played is because you can't hide from the experience. You go through the processes of the contracts, you go through the processes of the buyers, you go through the process of managing all of the pieces of paper. And as a result, you come out the other end of it better educated and more empowered in terms of understanding. I, for one, know a hell of a lot better what's actually happening on the property market in the background that I did not know was ever there. I also now will never look at property listings the same way again, because everything has completely changed for me. So the question that I have is, how many of you would like to up your game even further and learn even more about what it takes to become a powerful investor so that you can make all of those property purchases that you're interested in? It's okay to raise your hand, you're allowed. Okay, the reason I say that is that we're not sure of the exact date, if it's the 18th or the 19th of November, but on the 18th, 19th of November, our mentor, Quinton Swain, is gonna be coming back, and he's gonna be running a program that's separate from any of the other, even for the lifetime members, it's separate from those programs called Millionaire Market. And Millionaire Market is another real estate investment, like, course. It's actually the first course he created. So it's literally Clinton's first program that he ever did. And you will learn the auction system, you will learn the deal system, you will learn how to make transactions quickly in a market in order to build a property empire. So if you learned a lot here and you want to take another element into it and you want to play the game or you want to test yourself against Clinton, I can see that, like, yes. Then that's another opportunity for you to do so. Now, the normal retail rate, if you are to buy, is 1,500 ringgit for a one-day program.
It's one day, right?
Yeah, one-day program. It's actually on special early bird offer for 998 ringgit. But I'll take the extra, like, 9,000 if you want to give it to me. So it's for 998 for that program, Millionaire Market. It's never been in Malaysia before. It's the first time. And if you would like to experience a program that will test you again, and you can see if everything that you learned here can be reapplied in a different environment, then step into that, take action around that. We will send you more information on that with your permission. The other thing that we also want to talk about is Play to Win. Play to Win is actually centered more around general business skills and your ability to play general business skills. Now, based on the fact that we're expecting quite a large number, what I want to ask is, how many of you are in business or intend to go into business for yourselves in the near future? In business or intend to go into business for yourselves? Okay, fantastic. So Play to Win is a great foundational program. It is still free. For now, it is free, but that will be changing in the very near future, okay? So for now, it is free. You are able to log in following this link, frontiertrainings.com/KL/caveman. That is how you can register for Play to Win. I highly recommend you do so. It's 3 days. It is some of the most beneficial training I've ever received, frankly. And for it to be essentially at no cost is wild. Because I walk away with lessons from that that completely changed the dynamics of my business, my sales process, my approach to business, the way that I build business systems. And I cannot think the same way anymore as a result of Play to Win. It's in fact been such a compelling thing that it's completely made me change what I do professionally to create trainings and games that allow other people to have a similar experience. So if you are available or if you know anyone who is interested, please, please, please share with them Play to Win. It's the 1st through the 3rd of December. It will be held here. Although it cannot fit in this room, we are looking to have approximately 400 people at Play to Win. So if you thought that there was intensity in this game, imagine playing a game with 400 people. And imagine playing that game for 6 straight hours again. And then you have a rough idea of what it is like when you are tested to your limits. Now imagine doing that for an entire day and how much you learn. For many of us who've done programs together, we can tell you that actually 6 hours is not a long game. 6 hours is a very kind game. Yeah, that's considered a maybe short to medium game. But what you learn there, what you take away from the experience of it is extremely valuable. So these are two of the key programs that we're going to advise. There are additional programs that are taking place after the 3rd of December. There's also going to be a program called Sales Mastery. So if you're interested in improving your ability to create and to close sales, Sales Mastery is for you. That program will take you into an experience that you likely have never had before, where you will be pushed to test your limits in sales in a game-based environment and through activities from a person who is truly a genius when it comes to sales. The other thing after that will then be Financial Fortress, which will teach you investing, how to manage your money, and how to hold on to your money, because what's the point of having money if you're going to lose it? So Financial Fortress will support you with that. And lastly, then we're going to be going into Dynamic Impact. Dynamic Impact is a stage presence and presentation training. So for those of you who've been impressed with how the presentations are done by those lifetime members, how we use the space of the floor, how we deliver, how we don't have vocal pauses, how we're able to actually bring content to you in a very different way. A lot of that comes from those trainings, so I highly recommend that. Stephanie, as an example, was terrified of presenting. She literally, the story is that she got on, grabbed the microphone, and began weeping. Could you tell that based on what you saw today? No, right? You seem very composed. Frankly, you did a very good job. Let's give her a round. A round of applause. So that program will be taking place in December as well, as part of the block. So when the Frontier members are lifetime members, we do blocks, and you see about 14 days of training. And so when you do 14 straight days of training, you cannot walk out of it as the same human being. Okay? So a lot of what we do here will give you an idea of what it's like to do that. Now imagine the impact of having games-based training where it is safe for you to fail. I had negative a lot. I would rather spend the money in here, right? Rather than go out there and not know how I'm gonna feed my daughter. But in here, I now understand what it takes to find the right properties, to create collaborations, to have the relationships that are necessary to go into the property market and be successful. So what we encourage you to do is sign up for these programs, tell your friends about these programs, especially if you intend to get into the investment market, definitely come into that. If you want to test your mettle as an investor, come in there because Clinton goes super high gradient on these things, so I would highly recommend that if you really want to know what it's like to be squeezed, you do that. And Play to Win is always worth it. Even if you've done it before, I know people who've gone back and they replayed in Play to Win. As a matter of fact, in KLA, I replayed in Lords of Plantation when I did it. And I can tell you, having played the games means nothing. Having played the game once means nothing. Having played it twice means nothing. Having played it 3 times, also nothing. Because the level of depth of the games allows you to increase your value.